Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, so the main thing about this chapter is solution. And what is solution actually? Solution is a homogeneous mixture of two components. And what are those two components? The two components are here as follows. Solution is made up of two components, and those two components are solute and solvent. And what is solute? Solute is the component of the solution which is present in less quantity. And what is solvent? Solvent is the component which is present in the solution in more quantity. Let me give you an example of this, and then only you could understand what is solute and what is solvent. For example, if I take 10 gram of salt dissolved in 100 gram of water, I hope you would be thinking that this 10 gram of salt would be easily dissolved in water. That's true, but we have to differentiate that what is solute and what is solvent. So in this given example, as you can see, 10 gram is very much less than 100 gram, which means 10 gram is the solute and 100 gram is the solvent. It's very much simple. I take a reverse example. Let me see whether you could check it out or not. I give you 100 gram of salt and 10 gram of water. Then what would be the case for that? In this thing, the 100 gram of salt which is present in more quantity will be the solvent and the 10 gram of water will be the solute. Now let's do the types of solution that we know. So friends, these are the various types of solution that you can see here. Actually, there are main three types of solution as you can see. First is gaseous solution, the liquid solution and solid solution. As you can know that there are only three types of matter, solid, liquid and gas. Therefore, they are distributed in three parts. Like, if a gas is a solute particle, it can be dissolved in a solvent, which is gas. Similarly, a liquid, which is solute particle, it can be dissolved in gas. Similarly, solid can also be dissolved in gas. Similarly, by looking at each and every matter can be dissolved in each and every matter in it. Example, gas in liquid, liquid in liquid, solid in liquid, gas in solid, liquid in solid, solid in solid. So this makes a total of 9 types of solution that we can observe around us. Let me give you an example of each and every term also. When I talk about gas in gas, it means, as you can see, gas is a homogeneous mixture. Every gas can be dissolved in any gas. For example, smoke, air. These are the examples in which various kind of gas are miscible with each other and we cannot differentiate that which one is carbon dioxide gas or which one is water vapor. The next one is liquid in gas. As we know that we drink cold drinks, and in cold drinks we have carbonated water, and that carbonated water consists of carbon dioxide. It means that carbon dioxide is purposely dissolved in the Coke. So therefore, CO2 in cold drinks. Now, solid in gas. The example of this is when dust particles which are present in solid, which are present in a solid state, they can be also mixed up with gas and we cannot differentiate that. And hence, solid in gas makes an example of dust. Now moving to the next thing. The next thing is liquid solution, in which the gas can be dissolved in liquid. So if a gas can be dissolved in liquid, it means carbon dioxide can be dissolved in liquid water, as we know. Liquid in liquid is ethanol plus water. Solid in liquid is salt plus water. And moving to the next concept, that is solid in matter which is dissolved in solid. The first one is gas that can be dissolved in solid. This is an example of when H2 gas can be deposited on platinum rod. The second is liquid can also be dissolved in solid. And the last is solid can also be dissolved in solid. For example, any So friends, thank you for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and don't forget to subscribe ekeeta.com.